I think very good point, and something which is very much on our minds. So typically, so we have issued guidelines, and you may have seen the Swachh Bharat guidelines, which are quite broad, because we understand that we are such a vast country with such variety that one size will not fit all. But there are some broad guidelines for verification. And let me take you through the sort of key elements. So when a village is ready to become open defecation free or to announce that, so the Gram Panchayat, in an armed sabha, in an open meeting, they will all agree that the village is ODF, so that there's transparency and that people know. So that's one part of the process. After that, there needs to be a verification from outside the Gram Panchayat. So there's a block level checking.
So this checking or this parameter is of access or usage?
Right. Okay, good question. It's very clear for us that ODF, the definition of ODF, let me come to that, is both access, it's basically access, and there is no visible sign of feces around the village, right? So that's the definition, as you know. So clearly, and the focus is on usage. It's both. So when everyone agrees that all households have access to a toilet, and the reason we use the word access is because there could be shared toilets or community toilets. So they make a declaration, it's both, right? Then there is checking from outside the Gram Panchayat. Then there could be checking from the district. And sometimes in some states, the state government sends out state level officials. In Gujarat, they follow an even more rigorous process. They're hiring third party to do it at state level. So each state will follow this process. Then this is still of what we call self-declaration. Within 3 months of the self-declaration, there needs to be a verification process. So there's an informal verification before the self-declaration. Then there is a formal verification process to be done 90 days of the self-declaration. There's to be a second verification 6 months after self-declaration. Now, at the national level, we also do our due diligence. It's the primary responsibility of the state government. Water and sanitation being state subjects, but we have an accountability at the national level as well. So we do our due diligence in a couple of ways. We send out national level monitors who go out on a sample basis. We do third party verification, like the Quality Council of India, which is going on now, which is focusing on access and usage. And we are also going to commission an independent verification agent. We have contracted the independent verification agency, which will again go out on an annual basis and carry out third-party survey at a household level. Now, the sustaining of the ODF you asked about. We have developed a sustainability protocol in consultation with the state governments. So the idea is, how can you create an incentive for villages and Gram Panchayats to remain ODF, say year on year, right? So under the World Bank project, there'll be a financial incentive. We also need to create some mechanisms at the village level, right? Is the Nigrani Samiti still there? Are they still looking out for open defecators in the village post the declaration? Now, Haryana is announcing incentives to blocks for remaining ODF. So every state is now creating their own mechanisms. We are very clear that the sustaining of ODF is equally, if not more important than the declaration. So right now, this protocol was developed about 6 months ago. It's again work in progress. We need to strengthen this. But we're very clear that the focus on continuing to remain ODF is very important.